While families of the victims in the entire world mourn and grieve the lives of those lost in the ill-fated Dina aircraft which crashed on Sunday, our newsgisters who visited the crash site today were shocked at what they saw. Soldiers, police officers, touts and few Nigerians have turned the site into an amusement park and also an avenue for money extortion. Read their report below. Police and army officers barricaded a section to the right where they publicly demand money from Nigerian journalists who are trying to gain access to the site. The foreign journalists were not harassed. Behind the barricades were smaller groups of people who were all engaged in arguments as to what might have caused the crash. Some were drinking, others were laughing, a few were making merry and enjoying themselves while the cyber world mourns. A loud laughter seems to be coming from a group perched by the nearby fence. On getting there, we realized that the group of six guys and three girls were debating on what the families of the victims will do with the money they will receive from the airline's insurance company. Lastly, be prepared to pay some money to the touts if you plan on parking or setting up a booth anywhere within 3 kilometers. It seems all the touts in the area have found a way to capitalize on the situation as the search and rescue entered its third day. Our heart still goes out to the families of the victims, but our people perish for lack of knowledge as crash sites and accident scenes are now tourist attractions.